We've had a quarter one operational update from Xtract Resources, with the company saying it is mining ore at record levels from its Chepica gold mine in Chile. Well, for more, we are joined by the chief executive, Jan Nelson. So, Jan, you've opened up reef development on 5, 6 and 7 level. Stoping has commenced on 6. So talk to me about the stoping operations, because they were significant in the first quarter.
Yes, Sarah, thank you. First of all, we do a lot of development in terms of tunnels where we open up the bottom of the ore body that we're going to mine. And obviously that generates a lot of volume in terms of rock. But when we start stoping, we actually start at the bottom of those tunnels that we drive in, and we drill into the hanging wall, and then we sort of block cave down all the ore. So that allows us then to mine much more volume. And when you stope, you can generate more volume, you've got more flexibility, and that's why the volumes picked up significantly. But in order to get into that position, you have to do a lot of tunneling, and we've now finally done that. And then when we start stoping, a lot of rock comes out, and I think that's why we've hit the record. So when we restructured the whole mine after the earthquake, in the last quarter of last year, that's really now paying off. So I know it was very difficult and hard for investors at the time, but I think you can see that that plan in terms of stopping and redesigning the whole mine is paying off now.
Okay, you also say you've resolved the issue with recovered grades. What was the issue that needed to be resolved?
You know, we had some problems in the plant, the flotation cells, which we sorted out, but essentially it's very basic. If you don't put enough rock through the plant, you just won't fix the grade problem. You know, we've got ore bodies that are quite wide, and the grade varies anything from 0.5 gram to 4 grams a ton. On average, we block the ore body, so we sort of calculate the grade for the whole block, but you'll only get that grade if you mine the whole block. So if you're constantly not getting enough volume through the plant, so we're just milling 6,000 tons on a call of 10, you'll never get the grade right. And with Chepica, it's a volume game. You've obviously got to stay on the reef and make sure you don't have dilution, or in terms mine rock that doesn't have gold in it. But if you want to get the grade right at Chepica, you've got to put the volume through. And since we got the volumes right, the grades come right. It's as simple as that.
Okay. Now, as you say, the processing plant has been restarted. Is all going to plan in terms of functionality and safety?
Yes. No, we haven't had any incidents or accidents at the mine. So that's all going well. We've had one or two small issues with the plant starting up. So, you know, we had one of the conveyor belts break and one of the jaw crushers broke. But I think that's because we're finally getting a lot of volume through the plant. But those are all small things that we fix. It's normal operational things that happens on an operation. It's not material and it's not major things. So we've had a few breakdowns, but they haven't been material, and we fix them and then we carry on.
Okay, I'm just wondering how major my next question is, though, because your first land option payment for Chepica was due at the end of the first quarter. How are the renegotiations going for this, and will late payment jeopardize the project?
No, Sarah, not at all. No, negotiations are going quite well, but the particular gentleman that we're dealing with is a very old gentleman, and he's very, very thorough in how he does things. So he's not in a hurry to do things. And then legal teams have to check everything we do. So we went to him when the first payment was due and said, look, we'd like to renegotiate this. And he said, he gave us a verbal commitment that it's not a problem. You guys don't have to worry. It doesn't jeopardize what you're doing. We also have that on paper in a letter he wrote to us. So and now we're just negotiating. And first, in the first instance, we thought we'd give him shares to try and settle the payments. But we've subsequently opted to pay them cash, simply because shareholders are extremely worried about dilution, and we've committed to them that we won't dilute shareholders. So we've now reached almost an agreement with him where we will settle the payments in cash. He seems to be very happy with it. I had feedback yesterday. We can't disclose that to the market yet until we sign the contract. But what I can say is that it won't jeopardize the payments, and I think we will come out with a good end result for everybody without any dilution to the shell.
Okay, well, let's just to be clear here, because this sounds quite dodgy, Jan. Giving cash to an older gentleman, what do you mean by that?
No, I just, Mr. Bordoni, the owner, is old. You know, he's in his late 70s. So, it takes him a bit of time to it's not that you walk into his office and say, here's the terms, can we sign tomorrow? Mr. Bordoni takes his time. He goes through things very thoroughly. And because he's older, you know, his legal team looks at it. So it takes a lot of time. You know, it's not like you're dealing with somebody that's 25 years old, more impulsive, and says, yes, no, let's do the deal, or we've got it. You know, he takes his time, and he's got his legal team going. So it's frustrating because it delays things, and shareholders don't really know what's happening. But there is no issue, that I can tell you. We've discussed it with our nominated advisor. They're fully up to speed with where we are. And there is no issue with regards to those payments or the jeopardizing of the actual claim. And like I said, our nominated advisor has checked it. The only problem we have is we can't put those terms into the market until we physically haven't signed the contract, because they might change. You know, and then we'll frustrate shareholders by saying we've now reached this agreement. Tomorrow we change it again. And we have changed the agreement several times. That's just normal in terms of these types of negotiations. Unfortunately, these negotiations take time. But what I can tell shareholders without any issues that there is no encumbrance on the claim, and it will be a good outcome for everybody.
That's super. Well, it seems as though the word thorough permeates your business model. Now, just over 2 months ago, since you got approval to buy the Manica Gold Project in Mozambique. So what are you doing there, and when can we expect news flow from the project?
Well, I think shareholders can expect quite a lot of news flow in the coming months. We've been very quiet for the last 3 months, but we've done quite a lot of work. The bankable feasibility is almost complete. Actually, all the technical studies are complete, and we've run quite a big optimization on the project, and those results will be coming out. We've got a resource upgrade coming out on the project, and then also we are starting alluvial mining operations in June, and we'll give shareholders an update on that. So all in all, Manica is actually going very, very well.
And finally, Jan, when will I be introducing you as a mid-tier gold producer?
Well, I think that if we once we start mine construction, and once the alluvials are up to speed, I think we will probably reach mid-tier status. So that would probably be by the end of next year.
Excellent. Jan Nelson, Chief Executive of Xtract Resources, thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
Thanks, Sarah.